एकोनविंशः सर्गः
द 19th चैप्टर
तस्मिन्नेव ततः काले राजपुत्री त्वनिन्दिता रूपयौवनसंपन्नं भूषणोत्तमभूषितम्
इन दैट वेरी मोमेंट द फॉल्टलेस प्रिंसेस देवी सीता लुक्ड एट दैट रावण equipped with the best of ornaments, youthfulness and beauty.
Tato drishtvaiva vaidehi ravanam rakshasadhipam pravepata vararoha pravate kadali yatha.
Looking at Ravana, the king of Rakshasas, Devi Vaidehi, who is of a beautiful waist, started trembling like a plant in tree being shaken by gusts of wind.
Achhadyodaramurubhyam bahubhyam cha payodharau upavishta vishalakshi rudanti varavarnini.
Curling up, covering her waist with her thighs and her bosom with her arms, the large-eyed Devi Sita of a beautiful complexion started weeping in grief.
दशग्रीवस्तु वैदेहीं रक्षितां राक्षसी गणैः ददर्श सीतां दुःखार्तां नावं सन्नामि वार्णवे.
The ten-headed Ravana looked at Devi Vaidehi, who was being guarded by the groups of Rakshasis, who was being tormented with grief, and who looked like a ship drowned in the sea.
असंवृतायामासीनां धरण्यां संशितव्रतां छिन्नां प्रपतितां भूमौ शाखामिव वनस्पतेः.
Seated on the bare ground, looking extremely dejected, she looked like a broken branch of a large tree fallen on the ground.
मलमण्डनचित्राङ्गीं मण्डनार्हाममण्डितां मृणाली पङ्कदिग्धेव विभाति न विभाति च.
Her limbs smeared in all kinds of dirt and her body unornamented, even though she is worthy of the best of ornaments. She looked like mud-smeared lotus stem which is shiny but doesn't shine.
समीपं राजसिंहस्य रामस्य विदितात्मनः संकल्पहय संयुक्तैर्यान्तिमिव मनोरथैः.
She sat there as if moving ever closer to the best of kings, the knowledgeable Lord Rama, being pulled by her mind as the chariot and her willpower as its horses.
शुष्यन्तीं रुदतीमेकां ध्यानशोकपरायणां दुःखस्यान्तम पश्यन्तीं रामां राममनुव्रतां.
She was emaciated, weeping, alone and absorbed in her grief. Unable to see the end to her suffering, she was immersed in her thoughts of Lord Rama.
वेष्टमानां तथा विष्टां पन्नगेन्द्रवधूमिव धूप्यमानां ग्रहेणेव रोहिणीं धूमकेतुना.
She sat there coiled up, resembling the wife of the king of serpents. She sat there like the Rohini nakshatra, shadowed under the influence of Ketu graha.
वृत्तशीला कुले जाता माचारवति धार्मिके पुनः संस्कारमापन्नां जातामिव च दुष्कुले.
Even after being brought up in a righteous family that is pious and follows dharma, she is now being subject to discipline and hardships once again, as if she hadn't had that upbringing.
अभूतेनापवादेन कीर्तिं निपतितामिव आम्नायानामयोगेन विद्यां प्रशिथिलामिव.
She resembled falsely besmirched reputation and knowledge that was lost due to lack of practice.
Sannamiv mahakirtim shraddhamiv vimanitam पूजामिव परिक्षीणामाशां प्रतिहतामिव.
She resembled faded glory, slighted faith, dwindled prayer, and obstructed desire.
आयतीमिव विध्वस्तामाज्ञां प्रतिहतामिव. दीप्तामिव दिशंकाले पूजामपहृतामिव.
She looked as dejected, as a possibility destroyed, as a command negated, as the directions themselves set ablaze during dissolution, and as prayer that has been forcibly stopped.
पद्मिनीमिव विध्वस्तां हतशूरांचमूमिव प्रभामिव तमोध्वस्तामुपक्षीणामिवापगाम.
She was like a lotus creeper that was blighted, like an army which lost its valiant warriors, like radiance which was overcome by darkness, and like a stream that dried up.
Vedimiva paramrishtam shantam agnishikhamiva paurnamasimiva nisham rahugrastendumandalam.
Like a Vedic altar which was defiled, like a flame which was extinguished, and like a full moon night which was darkened by an eclipse.
Utkrushtaparna kamalam vitrasita vihangamam hasti hasta paramrishtam akulam padmini miva.
She appeared like a lotus with beautiful petals in a magnificent lotus pond which was destroyed by the frightened flaps of birds caused by ravaging thwarts of elephant trunks.
पतिशोकातुरां शुष्कां नदीं विस्रावितामिव परयामृजयाहीनां कृष्णपक्षनिशामिव.
Stricken with grief caused by separation from her husband, she appeared like a river that has gone dry. Devoid of her regular purification, she felt like the darkness of the waning fortnight.
सुकुमारीं सुजातांगीं रत्नगर्भगृहोचितां तप्यमानामिवोष्णेन मृणालीमचिरोद्धृतां.
A delicate lady with beautiful limbs who deserves to be in a jewel-encrusted palace now looked like a freshly plucked out lotus stalk being scorched under the sun.
गृहीतामालितां स्तंभे यूथपेन विनाकृतां निःश्वसन्तीं सुदुःखार्तां गजराजवधूमिव.
She looked like a royal she-elephant separated from her herd and tied to a pole, who was dejected and sighing in grief.
एकया दीर्घया वेण्या शोभमानामयत्नतः नीलया नीरदापाये वनराज्या महीमिव.
With a single braid of long dark hair, she looked effortlessly radiant, like earth covered by a series of dark trees at the end of the rainy season.
उपवासेन शोकेन ध्यानेन च भयेन च परिक्षीणां कृशां दीनां अल्पाहारां तपोधनां.
She was in a pitiful state, shriveled and emaciated due to regular fasting, sorrow, brooding, fear and minimal food. She was rich only in her austerities.
आयाचमानां दुःखार्तां प्राञ्जलिं देवतामिव भावेन रघुमुख्यस्य दशग्रीव पराभवम्.
Tormented with grief, she looked like a devata who with folded hands was seeking the best of Raghavas, Lord Rama, to defeat the ten-headed Ravana.
समीक्षमाणां रुदति मनिन्दितां सुपक्ष्मतां रायत शुक्ललोचनां अनुव्रतां राममतीव मैथिलीं प्रलोभयामास वधाय रावणः.
Looking at the blameless Devi Maithili with beautiful eyelashes, and broad white eyes which were reddened, who was weeping incessantly in her thoughts of Rama, Ravana started trying to entice her as if inviting his own death.
Ityarshe Srimad Ramayane Sundara Kande Ekonavimsha Sargah.
Thus, the 19th chapter in Sundara Kanda of Valmiki Ramayanam is complete.